of service y'all ever get from me.
It's conspiracy, and it was meant to happen. The lottery was a fraud. $38 million of revenue, King County, with 100 licenses. Then $27 million in Pierce County. It's ridiculous that we can see this kind of wealth building that takes place and the African-American community is locked out, chasing an opportunity that has, where the ship has already left.
Chime in. Chime on in. Let's join together. Because, I mean, that's the only way for us to get out of these things is together.
Do strength in numbers.
There we go. There's no more running and hiding and watching everybody else do it. If so, you're going to get left out because we ain't stopping, period. And we ain't scared.
Couple of things are going on. Thing number one, thing number two. All right, let's get sorted here. Resolutely. So what we're going to talk about today is the failure. Please comply for once. Just Apple shit, please comply. Sit in your place. All right. Jesus. We're going to talk about some compliance issues that LCB has Oh, that's so good. Bye-bye. We're going to talk about some compliance issues that LCB has with respect to public information requests. And we're also going to cover the NAACP moment at today's board hearing, where the economic chair definitely had something to say. Okay. Boy, I just got an inappropriate text message just now. I hope nobody saw that shit. Anyway, God, it's just what a calamity day. Oh my God. Just stop. Anyway, and I got to tell you guys, I am not fully there. My ex and I talked for like 5 hours last night until like 4 a.m. So I woke up this morning. I was hit. But anyway, it's all good. It's all good. Yeah, it was a really cool talk. We need to have it. It was awesome. So let's go back here. And I'm going to show some folks some things. All right. This is the board meeting. We'll get to the public information stuff in a minute. But I'm going to show folks. I'm going to do a share screen and show some folks what happened here. And this is a testimony of the well, you'll see who it is. All right. You're going to see in just a minute. All right. All right.
Thank you. Darrell Powell.
Come on, brother. Here he is.
Good morning.
Good morning. Happy New Year's to everyone. My name is Darrell Powell. I'm here in the capacity of representing the NAACP. I'm the Vice President of Economic Development, and I've been working since June, maybe May, with the Washington African American Cannabis Association, and on the phone calls at the task force and the work groups to bring about what I consider something that's equitable, given we were left out in the first process. I've come to understand that there's 500 and plus licenses that are out in the community. And if LCB and the legislature had centered equity in when 502 was being written, and centered equity when 2870, and centered equity when 1443, we wouldn't find ourselves here chasing an opportunity that has, where the ship has already left. And because if the lottery was equitable, African Americans would have been a part of the lottery and would have got their fair share. So
So I expect that this second time around, at our meager request, that of the next 300 licenses, in the form of 38 to 40 a year, go to African-American and other BIPOC communities. I would expect that you would understand and know that the reason why King County is doing so well is because all the white licensees have capitalized King, Capitol Hill, have capitalized Magnolia, have capitalized all the dense areas, and they're generating $4 to $5 million per store. So I wouldn't expect that the next 38 licenses go to Mason County or Douglas County or Whitman County. We can compete in dense areas. We can compete in areas that are populated, in the areas that we were arrested when we went to jail.
So you guys get the point, all right? He's on fire, all right? On fire. In this check, all right? The conspirator, right? Look at that sad face, man. She's part of the problem, okay?
Guilty.
You know, and that's what's up, all right? So let me come up out of the screen share for a minute. She's part of the problem, okay? Oh, hi. Look who's joined us.
What's up?
Announce your phone.
Yeah, I'm here, man.
All right. Joe Aurelian Hall is here. For you guys who don't know anything about this, the three of us are co-plaintiffs. Kevin Shelton is involved as well, but John Novak, Sinjo Aurelian Hall, and I are co-plaintiffs in the federal case. So what we
Hey, Sinjo. Kevin, how's it going?
Good. Hey, Novak. How you doing, brother?
Hello. Doing good.
So that was pretty explosive. I mean, like, you know, and given what you've said today, Kevin, and as we go further into this in a minute, we're going to show what you sent me in terms of the letter. Why don't you explain a little bit more about some of the materials you sent me today and the connection between these people and between what's-her-face there, Ollie Garrett. Just sure. To do a quick recap for we need to do this every episode, actually, until, you know, we just should do this. So the quick recap is you were grandfathered. They came in LCB pretending to be cops. You were scared of that, intimidated. You surrendered your license. Then you subsequently found out that you were actually grandfathered by statute. Your lawyer told you he was afraid to sue them because if he won, they would come after him. And then you got involved with the NAACP. Take it from there.
Okay, so yeah. I contacted Mr. Hankerson from the NAACP. Can you hear me?
Yeah, who is?
Oh, and he's the president for the Northwestern region of the NAACP.
Yep.
And he said he was in the process of penning them a letter regarding, you know, the atrocities. One thing too that they said here that this gentleman said during the video you just played and that they've said periodically as that we were locked out. Some of us were locked out. That's a fallacy. Uh-huh. We were forced. Those of us that were in business were forced out.
Uh-huh. Gotcha.
That's a little bit different than being locked out.
Yeah. Well, I think he might have said the locked out of the lottery.
Right, right, right. So
that we could agree on.
Right on.
Yeah.
So
lottery, like let me tell you a story real quick. Back in Boston, like Whitey Bulger, I think it was. Okay. You got to think about who Whitey Bulger was. This guy he won the lottery. And then there was another case for this cop who admitted that they were like stealing cocaine and shit, you know, in the 80s. He does his time. He comes out and he wins the lottery. Come on, man. They fix these lotteries. You know, it's crazy.
Yeah.
Please continue.
Sure. So he penned a letter. Mr. Hankerson penned a letter to the Liquor Cannabis Board over the summertime. And, basically we showed that letter on the last Weedwraps. But, yep. I'm still hopeful and crossing my fingers that we hear back because what is all the meetings and all the, the speeches and the marching going on with these guys if they're not going to communicate with the people that were injured by the fake cops doing business as a liquor cannabis board?
Yeah, and that's, oh my God. Yeah, and that's exactly right. That is exactly right, sir. I don't like this new computer. I really don't. I mean, I don't like my new MacBook. And it's like a year old now. It's an M1, the Air. And it's just, the thing seems so imprecise and just, I don't like it.
So that's dated in the computer world, right?
Yeah, well, yeah. Well, I didn't like it from the get-go. I should have, I don't know what I could have done. Spent more money and got the next one up. I don't know. Jeez. Yeah. So then the other thing is that, I can't talk about that right now. Okay. Let's just do that right now. All right. So the other thing is I want to share is going to the missing information. Okay. Oh, and by the way, no, there was just to finish up though. So they approach you. There were several members of the community, the mm-hmm. so-called leaders of the Black community who approached mm-hmm. you. And you know, they said, well, you can get your license back, but you're going to have to give up 49% of your company. Is that right?
That's correct.
Yeah. And then the people involved with that were whom again?
That would be Nate Miles and Ollie Garrett and Chris Bennett, senior from the Seattle Medium newspapers and some other Black radio stations in Seattle and Oregon.
Yes. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Absolutely.
I got you on that. Okay. So,
we didn't know anything. Myself and my brother didn't know anything about a social equity program. We were approached by my father-in-law, who's cousins with Chris Bennett from the Seattle Medium. We were approached and asked, weren't you guys forced out of your business over in Skyway, Washington, which is a Black neighborhood in Seattle. And to date, Have a Hearts in that area, and they've done about $40 million worth of business since we've been gone. But, you know, and we're trying to survive and get back what's ours. But yeah, them guys approached me. And when I say them guys, that was my father-in-law approached me, who he's cousins with Chris Bennett. And, you know, Chris Bennett and Nate Miles are good friends. And, you know, they put together a plan and told us to just lay low and they'll handle the minor details. And for us to pen the letter to Ollie Garrett, a Dear John letter saying what happened.
Yep.
And we did that and we just laid low. And somehow I got a call saying that the deal is going to be off because too many hands are in the pot and Ollie Garrett and Nate Miles don't want to deal with us. So fast forward a couple of meetings after, so about less than a month later, this new gentleman joined the social equity task force meetings, and his letter sounded really similar to ours. And he's from Emerald City Collective Garden.
Right, we're about to pull that up for you in just a minute. Keep going. Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I was pretty, you know, devastated. I didn't even have a chance to sit down and negotiate anything or talk to these guys. Only one time. I never had a chance to negotiate the, you know, my piece and my brother's piece of the license. There was done, you know, they were putting that all together themselves, and there was some infighting that happened, and they said, you know, to hell with Kevin and Ben Shelton. We're moving on. See you later. Have a nice life. You get nothing. But we risked our lives. And we risked our family members invested with us. We pulled ourselves up by our bootstraps, and we should get nothing?
Yes. Right. And so, yeah, here's that letter, by the way. It was Mike Asai with Emerald City Collective Gardens.
Yeah.
And basically, this echoes the letter. Everybody's seen it. It's on my Scribd account. Everybody's seen your letter. It goes into there, okay? And he talks about Game Collective in here too, okay?
Yeah.
Which is interesting too, because Game Collective was the model for safe access to cannabis we now see today with cannabis retail. I felt more empowered to make the dream come true. And we know what happened to Game, all right? And Breon, right? So basically, they found a way to get everybody Black out. And you cannot, just like the guy was saying earlier, the economic advisor at NAACP, you can't just say that that these are issues of circumstance. It's the new Jim Crow. And yet people come at us for bringing it up so ardently. Well, what are we supposed to do? I go through this stuff. Honestly, I go through this stuff with my family because I know they can never get on this thing and say, wow, good work. You know, it's not going to happen. You know, it's not going to happen. And it's so hard, even for people who aren't family or whatever. They see it going on, but it's just kind of like, they just don't know what to say. They can't get involved. Even your lawyer said, I can't do this.
Yeah.
How disturbing is that?
Yeah. Is that how the legal system is working now?
Yeah, that's exactly right. And so, yeah, your guy continues on here. I've got the letter. Folks, I may post this later on, or I may not. We've got it right here. It's all right there. It's just insane, the kind of things that happen here. And I'm also going to show a connection before we talk about the public records aspect of this, because basically what it is they're not retaining emails. The same thing that Jenny Durkan isn't doing. They're not retaining emails, okay? And that's a violation, all right? And this time I'm going to get them. I'm just going to sit back and wait for the Jenny Durkan case to finish up, you know, and then go after them for what's called res judicata, you know, the similar cases, you know, not res judicata, but stare decisis, where, you know, cases that were similar in concept should be decided similarly, okay?
Yeah.
So let me find one more thing, though, because I have a couple of pages that I found, and I'm trying to find these pages now without divulging some text messages I just got online. So let's just hang on a second about that, because I have them. Just give me a second, guys.
Right on.
Yep. Won't take long. I have them pulled aside here, too. Oh, wait. What's it? Ugh. Oh, I know where it is. Okay, cool. One second. Yep, got it right here. All right. So take a look. We're going to take a look now at what Ollie Garrett is involved in and the people that she's with, okay? All right, here we go. Let me do a screen share again. One second. All right. Oh, my God, dude. Where did my screen go? Okay. It's been a challenging day, but I'm all right. I'm all right. Here we go. Let's find that. Okay, so let me show you this, all right? This is NWTEI, the Northwest Technology Equity Initiative. There is Nate Miles, our buddy there. Oh, that didn't do the screen share, did I? No, hold on. Struggle bus. Share screen. I need an admin so fucking bad. All right, so here we go. Right. Now we see this, right? There's yep. NWTEI. Okay. Nate Miles is right there, chairman of the board and co-founder. And I don't know who this Carissa Gardner is. We'll have to check into her too, okay? Mm-hmm. They're both co-founders. And who else is on this panel? The board of directors, Ollie Garrett, Miss Sad Face from the video from today.
Whoa.
Uh-huh. Sandra, you rocking with that one?
It was funny because that was exactly what I was thinking when I was watching it. I was like, damn, their faces. They're sad pandas.
Sad pandas. And you're busted, guys. It's just a matter of time. And Ollie knows what I know. I can't talk about it. She knows I know. And Pepper, quiet. And she's lucky that I wasn't there in the meeting this morning. Levi, it's tough when you know people named Levi and Eli. It's tough. But Levi Lyon had sent me the message this morning, but I just missed it in terms of the meeting today. But next time, we'll be ready for public comment next month for their meeting. See you there, Ollie. But she knows the jig is up. And that's the word, the jig is up. People say gig is up. Well, the gig can be up too, but the jig is up. That's the term. And also it's jibe, but not jive. Anyway, jive is what they are. Things don't jibe because they are jive. I used it in a sentence.
So, right. English 101.
Conjunction, junction, what's your function? Pauses and phrases.
He's going back now.
Yeah, always the cunning linguist. Yeah. All right, so here we go. Let's go on back here to the share screen again, and I'll show you one more thing. Pepper, you are trippendicular. All right, so let's go here now to collections and debt recovery. When I look back at the chain of emails that you had, Kevin,
Yeah.
I looked at Ollie Garrett's email address, and it's PMT Solution, Payment Management Technology. Okay. They're involved in government stuff. It helps businesses save money and manage their receivables. Collection solutions, okay? Like receivables, basically they're bill collectors or they're, you know, it's, so there's something going on there. I just kind of think it's interesting, all these hats she's wearing. And I'm not above people wearing a lot of hats. We all wear a lot of hats. But the hats she's wearing, I think there's a little funk up underneath every one of them. Yeah. I'm very concerned about that and what is all going on with these companies and all of this, you know, and why the NAACP won't get back with you after the strident testimony that we heard. You know, we're going to write him too. And just simply ask, you know, you got a former NAACP legal chair. You got a brother in need. You got many brothers and sisters in need. You got communities that have been raped, pillaged, plundered. What are you doing? Why can't we be involved? How can we help you help us? How can we help you in your stated purpose?
Absolutely.
So last thing I'm gonna show you now is the issue of the missing text messages and what I told them, because they know they're busted on that too. I just haven't had the time to sue them yet, but this really shows it all, right? Tacitly, I'll run that word search, tacitly, all. Here we go. Pepper, you need to really chill. Yeah, honey, honey child, I love you, but you need to chill. All right. Oh God, but let's chill. Okay, 80s hits for 1,000. Anyway, gosh. So these, I should have one of them pulled up for you, but basically, you know, we asked for text messages involving some agents and staff about enforcement, okay? And we had a conference, Cindy, remember we had that conference call with the lawyer about that?
Mm-hmm.
And I gave him an extra month, didn't I?
Yeah.
I was cordial. What was my demeanor like in that meeting?
You were just very calm and you were just getting your point across, not in a rude way. You were just like, look, like, this is what I want. I'm just requesting this. Can we please have it?
Right.
Basically what you were just saying. Can you help me so we can help you to help us?
That's right. And objection, move the strike. I love the witness a little bit, but whatever. It is what it is. I mean, my own objection against myself. Objection, move the strike, bitch. So anyway, what it amounts to is that these text messages that we asked for involve enforcement. We had to narrow what we asked for. And I did that willingly. Sinjo was on the phone, you know, and John was on the phone. And so she writes me back and says, Dear Christopher King, and this was on January 3rd, this letter for the further response to your public records request, the Washington State Liquor and Cannabis Board, WSLCB, received your request on September 8th, 2021. We last wrote to you regarding your request on December 15th and provided a fourth installment of records. By the way, this is what they do. They string this shit out. Because you can't sue them until they finish all their installments, okay?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Right. We continue to consult with internal staff regarding text messages, which may be responsive to your request. We need an additional 10 business days or until January 18, 2022 to provide you with any additional records should they exist. If you have any questions, please contact me. So I wrote Missy Norton, that's her name, Missy Norton. I wrote her back and I said, look, short again, eh? You know, coming up short again, thereby tacitly admitting that WSLCB did not retain the documents as required by law. Same as Jenny Durkan, all right? And I said, this time I'll just wait for the final judgment against her using my pals over at the Seattle newspaper whenever they finish mopping up the floor with her. Then I'll argue stare decisis and see how far the courts bend over backwards to pervert the cause of justice. Who knows? Maybe I'll catch another unwritten order, like from Judge Ransmeyer, attempting to trample my First Amendment or free press, Fourth Estate rights and privileges. Lots of laughs, you know? And I said, and I'm sure the establishment pukes will continue to find a way to blame me or my people for this giant shit show, right? Right. Ciao. It's unbelievable. It's unbelievable. So here we sit.
Yeah, here we sit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Ain't nothing happening. Yeah, right? Just
Happy like New watch, Year.
But like watching sap fall
Happy
off.
New Year. Hands.
All right, let's do the roundabout. John, closing thoughts.
Doesn't surprise me, actually, that what you described, not only are they attacking BIPOC, but pretty much wiped out the medical side, too, and left in it, you know, nothing. You can't go out there and be assured of anything as far as the quality. So...
Yeah. Oh, and listen, but we're on that, on the quality thing. One of the elements of our lawsuit, we are making a difference, by the way, because I can assure you of that in ways we can't talk about publicly right now. But one of the ways we can talk about publicly is the testing. John, what, I can't keep track of all of this, but they have noted that they're going to be doing more testing now. Could you tell us about that? Because that's your area of expertise right there.
Well, it's kind of still up in the air yet. I don't think the rules are finalized, but it would set up a program to go in and be able to just randomly go into a store and get a sample and then have it tested.
Uh-huh.
So that's a start, I guess, but we'll see what happens. I'm hearing from some people that it's kind of a non-starter, but we'll see.
Yeah, more lip service. Like, yeah, there's that's a song by Elvis Costello called Lip Service, and that's probably what it is. Your lip service is all you'll ever get from me. Anyway. Sinjo Hall, your comments.
No, I'm kind of right there with John. Like, it's just kind of surprising with everything.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I don't see how they can get away with, like, you know, not keeping records. And I do agree with you. Like, there needs to be some sort of, like, resolution or whatever that big word was that you used for, you know, the same thing with Jenny Durkan. There has to be reprimandation, like, in the same way.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Something's got to happen. I mean, it's really like it's got to happen that way. Stare decisis. Yeah.
Yes. Thank you.
Yeah. I remember all the confirmation hearings for Clarence Thomas were in, and I remember like Strom Thurmond, man, you know, he was a lawyer and stuff. And Strom Thurmond, he'd be like, stare decisis. It's like, man, you just like Bama ass. Fucking, he puts a punk on that so hard. Star in the sizes. Sounds so nice.
Oh, man.
Googly, googly, Fred. Anyway, final words from you, Mr. Shelton.
Man, hey, look, this is the new Black Wall Street. I just want to say to anybody that's in any kind of position of power in Washington State or any other state, to sit back and watch us burn, your responsibility to act is now. To sit back and watch us burn, look, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. And there's been many roadblocks set up, so we can be in the positions that we are now. It was clearly planned. It was clearly calculated, and, it's got to stop. And there needs to be fair redress under state and federal to those of us who are injured. And I'm calling to those that were injured and they may be scared to speak up. What else do you have? What else are you going to do? What are you going to do? Stand up, speak out. If you got shelled out of the business, you know, chime in.
Yeah.
Chime on in. Let's join together. Because, I mean, that's the only way for us to get out of these things is together. That's
it. Strength in numbers.
There we go. There's no more running and hiding and watching everybody else do it. If so, you're going to get left out because we ain't stopping, period. And we ain't scared. I mean, yeah, look at the news. Look what's happened to us all anyway. We ain't scared. Scared of what?
Right. I ain't afraid of you, motherfuckers. Yeah. What's that line from anyway? I don't remember, but yeah. I got another one for you. Remember Network?
King's
I'm mad as hell, and I'm not gonna take it anymore. Yeah.
Kings of comedy, though. Kings of comedy. I ain't afraid of you, motherfuckers. Kings.
I ain't afraid of you, but kings of comedy. Right, right.
Bernie Mac, rest in peace, brother.
Right, oh my God, every Steve Harvey, Bernie Mac,
DL.
Right, you know, Hughley, and what you call it? Who's the other one? Sad. Sad the Entertainer.
Sad the Entertainer. Yes.
Yeah, Sad himself up. I'm gonna be drunk. All right, folks. I'm gonna lead us out with a certain little ditty. Alexa, play Elvis Costello Lip Service. Oh, I don't have it. Wait, Alexa. Alexa, play Lip Service by Elvis Costello.
Alexa is like, not today.
Lip Service by Elvis Costello. Alexa! Lip Service by Elvis Costello. Lip Service by Elvis Costello.
Brother, she ain't hearing
you. This just gets funnier and funnier.
Oh, there it is. I got it! Lip Service! Get for me. Yeah, I know, right? Yeah, lip service is all you'll ever get from them. It's so true, though. But yet, we keep on because that's what I do, and it's hard. It's hard. It really is hard, but we're going to do what we have to do, and we'll talk tomorrow, I'm sure. I got to run, got shit to do. Love you guys.
All right, we'll see you.